you take that jump, you don't feel the fall. Hope when the water rises, you built a wall. Hope when the crowd screams out, you're screaming your name. Hope if everybody runs, you choose to stay. Hope that you fall in love and it hurts so bad. Say they all add up.
What I wish I could tell my first year self is probably that things will be just fine. They will fall all into place eventually. And lastly, I would like to tell myself to not just buy a weekly planner, but maybe to also use it once in a while.
I'd say the only constant is change. And if you can hold on to that for dear life, you'll come out the other side better for it. And don't score assessments in other people's classes. Even if you know you can get away with it, it's not worth it. Just pay attention and learn time management.
My parting words would just be that nobody gets through this program alone, so use the people around you and speak up because your voice matters.
Embrace the uncertainty. Embrace the full spectrum of human suffering. Spend less time thinking about how to be helpful and more time on how to hear somebody differently than they've ever been heard. Embrace how difficult it is to be human and operate from there.
So two things that I would tell my first year self now would be stop every once in a while and have a moment of self-reflection. The days can go really, really slowly, but the years looking back actually go really fast. And I think it's important to really stop and realize like what amazing things you're accomplishing as a budding psychologist, not only professionally, but also personally as well. And second, I would say find your people. For every moment of stress, and there will be a lot of them, have a moment of laughter. I would say commiseration with your people is a key coping mechanism.
Believe in your ability to make change as a student and as a therapist. Let yourself laugh at the ridiculous moments that are inevitable and will make for some wonderful memories. Be kind to those around you. Take lots of pictures so you have them for your fourth year slideshow and beyond. And lastly, know that it will be a windy road and ultimately it will lead you where you are meant to be.
My advice would be to trust the internship and externship process. You'll end up in the right place.
So my advice is to remember that there's way more to your life than LIU and your schoolwork.
Similarly, my advice to my first year self would be to not take things so seriously.
Cheers.
Cheers.
What would I tell my first year self? Don't feel guilty for prioritizing relationships. They're just as important as studying. The friends you'll make in this program are amazing, and it's okay to value the fun you'll have together, the joy of seeing them grow, and the support they offer. Self-care is not frivolous like you think it is. And first year me, you seriously need to work on your willingness to ask for help. You're lucky to have a kind and courageous faculty mentor, but it's going to take you so long to tell her anything. Don't be ashamed to speak up.
There are going to be a lot of moments throughout your time at LIU that are going to be stressful and overwhelming. But I promise you, there is a light at the end of this tunnel. So take those vacations, spend time with your friends and family, cry in the lodges, say no when you can't take on anymore. I feel so lucky that I got to know every single one of you.
A piece of advice that I would give to first year Allegra would be to practice self-care frequently and find new hobbies.
To my first year self, please stop being afraid to speak up because you have a lot to contribute. Trust me.
I think the main sentiment that I have is the importance of being kind to oneself, especially in a program like this, and not in a self-care type of way, not in a take a bubble bath and meditate type of way, which is also important, but what I mean is more of the what type of voice is in your head, what type of monologue are you having, is it productive, not productive in the sense of am I getting work done, but you know, am I being the self that I want to be, and am I listening to a voice that I like that is good for me.
Try to enjoy the process, since you really don't know where you're going to end up or what anything is going to lead to. So even though there's a lot of forward-looking applying to things for the next year, try to enjoy the here, now, and the moment.
Hi, everyone. The advice I'd love to share is a reminder to never stop being yourself in this work. I think it was easy for me, and perhaps it's easy for all of you at different times, to think that you need to know more or change this about yourself or change that. And what I've learned throughout these years is that the more that I can embrace who I uniquely am as a person and a therapist and bring that to the work, the more joyful the work is and the stronger my connection with patients. So I invite us all to never stop being our unique full selves.
The most important lesson I've learned over the past 4 years is the importance of self-compassion and of self-kindness. Not only does it allow me to be a stronger and more effective clinician, but it also allows me to be a more complete and vivacious human. This is my greatest wish for each of you.
Hi, everyone. Prioritize your relationships, whether that means relationships with your peers in your cohort or faculty members, or relationships in your personal life with your family and friends, because in a few years from now, it's not gonna matter whether you got an A or an A minus on a paper. What will matter are the relationships and connections that you built and maintained, the type of friend that you were, partner, daughter, son, sister, brother. So prioritize those relationships.